I don't even see the husky jerk.
No, I think he grabbed it. He wanted it.
Oh, nice.
It's a gorgeous fish. This beautiful net feels like a little aquarium net.
Look at the colors on that fish. I could catch these all day, every day of my life.
Let's go fishing. People, when you're in the mood, let's go fishing. Well, it's just me and you. Head on down to the fishing hole. Grab your hat, get your pole. Let's go fishing. When you're in the mood.
Canadian Sport Fishing is brought to you by Rapala, premium fishing gear crafted from experience. Yamaha, conquer outdoors. Defend products, eco-friendly protection from biting insects. Dickies, quality workwear since 1922.
Aaron, good job.
Nice. Feels like a good walleye.
You know, when you come up here to God's Lake, if you want the full experience, the full Monty, you have to go for all the different species of fish. And right now we're taking advantage of the conditions because you can see it's overcast. And if you look behind us, there's actually a rain cell, which means walleye. Perfect conditions.
Oh yeah.
And Aaron, you got a nice one on.
Perfect little walleye chop.
I'm gonna get ready to grab it for you.
So many different species here on God's Lake too.
Yeah, are you okay? Do you want me to give you a hand here?
Sure. It's a nice
fish. We're fishing out of really nice deep boats. See if I can just, come here. One more time. Just a little closer. Good size average. I'm trying to be gentle with them. You know, I don't want you to lose it, but we're using barbless hooks.
Yeah.
And I'm trying to be gentle with this
guy. He's hooked well, though.
Look at, that's a gorgeous Elk Island Lodge walleye. He's got that jig, look, right in the roof of the mouth.
It's perfect.
He did great. And I'm just going to try to, without getting him,
here,
let me hug him here.
Got him under control?
I got him under control for now. So what I'm going to do is switch hands, and I'm going to do the classic underneath the gill plate. So what I'm doing, I'm not putting my fingers in the actual gill rakers, because we don't want to damage them, but that's a nice fish.
Beautiful way to start.
But you know, look at the conditions. These are walleye conditions. It's beautiful. Okay, let's just get it back.
Very nice.
Gonna hold
good
it
way to start. I just lost a fish too.
I know. Was it about the same size?
It was about the same size, yeah.
Good. We're just gonna give him a couple seconds and let him swim out of my hands. Here we go, beautiful.
Nice.
I noticed that you're using a much lighter jig head than I am.
It is.
So you're getting a much fluttering action. I'm getting more of a really fast up and down drop.
Yeah, and that was the second fish I had on, so we might wanna switch to a lighter jig head. This is, I think it's less than a quarter ounce and has a nice big quality hook on there.
That's a serious hook. It almost reminds me of the hooks that are used for bass fishing, you know, when you're getting fish out of the slop and stuff.
But you look at the size of these. This is a 4-inch paddle tail Trigger X minnow. And the reason I like this particular hook is because it has a light jig head and a big hook, and it's for redfish, I believe. I got it in Florida when I was fishing with you. So
I think you can call it a walleye jig head now.
Now it's a walleye jig head.
It's working for walleye really
exactly.
well.
Exactly. But it's perfect.
Starting to get warm up. The rain stopped,
hit
that's perfect.
The exact same way as the last one.
Aggressive like.
I cast way out and I let it sink down to the bottom and I just kind of did a little lift and drop and he hit it exactly the same way.
Yeah. Beautiful. Now we are fishing rock structure and you know, the break is anywhere from about 10, 12 feet down to about 20 and then it drops off. Like behind us is about 30 feet of water. And our guide Barry said, that's the pattern this time of the year. We're here in July. So this, we're getting into a summer
Pike.
Pattern. You know what? No problem.
Wow, look at that.
Oh, what's he got in his mouth?
Is it a sucker? I can't tell.
A burbot.
A burbot.
Whoa.
Oh, look at that.
How did you do that?
Look at
you know
this.
What? It's in good shape. We can have it for dinner.
No,
I've never heard of that. That's amazing. Look
I
at the
size. Dead bourbon. Look at that.
I think our baits are too small. I'm serious. Look at the size of that. What it inhaled, right? That's amazing.
It's almost as long as a pike.
Yeah.
The pike wasn't much longer.
Yeah. It's just funny that, wow, you know, the way it worked out, the pike got off and you hooked the bourbon.
Yeah. Maybe he wants his bourbon.
He couldn't even swallow it. He only had the head in his mouth. That's awesome.
Nice.
What a goal. Aaron, there's just something about getting a fish hitting a crankbait, especially a walleye. I love jigging for them.
It's awesome.
But crankbaits are awesome. And look at, he's got that scatter wrap right in the side of the mouth.
Beautiful.
Good job, Aaron.
Very
get
nice.
Him up here. Look, I love the colors of the walleyes here at
yeah, they're really golden.
God's Lake. And I got to be careful because that hook actually came out. So I'm just going to pinch it off. Get it out so I can show the viewers. I'm gonna hold the fish up. Just gonna drop that over the side.
It's a nice fish.
Yep. So this is, you know, this is probably average for here. It's a nice walleye from God's Lake. We're staying at Elk Island Lodge. I'm not sure of the total length, but I'm guessing he's about 22, 23 inches.
Yep.
But look, you know, they call him yellow walleye in many areas. Look at that nice sheen right down to the belly. That's a big board.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
So we start, actually we'll hold it up for the camera so they can see like that. We'll start up here.
It's 25.
It's 25.
Yep.
So we're gonna be releasing it. So we'll put him back in the net, Aaron.
Thank you.
See if he'll revive for a little bit. You know, the water's still pretty cold. It's probably in the 60s on the surface, but we'll just give him a chance.
Oh, there he goes.
Good. You know, if you love to fish crankbaits for multi-species of fish, but especially for walleye, this Rapala scatter wrap crank is ideal, and it comes in two models. This is the deep diving lip. There's also a regular model that goes down to about 5 to 7 feet. But because here at God's Lake, the walleye tend to be a little bit deeper. You can get them shallow, you can get them anywhere, almost like pike. But you can see these rocky shorelines tell you that the water goes down pretty steep. So it goes anywhere from about 5 to 12 feet. That's the running depth of the lure. And I've been slow cranking it, just so you know, Aaron. I haven't been really working it. Really slow, and I'm using a walleye rod. This is a two-piece. It's made by Rapala. It's part of their walleye team, and it's a little bit softer than I would use, let's say, if I was cranking for smallmouth bass or largemouth bass, because I want that hesitation before I set the hook. So I want to make sure if it's a walleye, because sometimes they hit lazy hits. So when you feel something on that you don't believe is bottom, you keep cranking, and then you ease back, add some torque, and then give it a couple of hook sets. So you want that little bit of just a slack in the line, not slack, but a little bit of lag before you really hammer it, instead of giving it a really sharp hook set where you might even pull the hook out of the fish's mouth. You know, when you got windy conditions like this, a lot of rocky structure, especially up here at God's Lake, we're at Elk Island Lodge, we're throwing crankbaits for big northerns. Look at this guy. It's a gorgeous fish. This
beautiful
net feels like a little aquarium net to try to get him in.
Look how he inhaled that. Oh!
Trying to hold him in. Nice walleye.
Beautiful.
Now let's check out, look at, did he want that crankbait? Can you see that? That's the Rapala crank?
Yep. Yep.
You can barely see it because it is down there. Okay, if you want to get the pliers, look at. Did he want it or what?
He inhaled that crank and wrap.
That's a nice trophy walleye. And okay, quick, get the pliers. We're going to get it out and we're going to get it back in the water. Here, I'll try holding it for you.
Yep.
Just be careful. He's got teeth.
Holy smokes.
He inhaled it.
He inhaled it all right.
You know, the key to using these crankbaits is actually to fish the windy side of points and structure, because that's where these big walleye are prowling looking for food. I liken them to wolves that are hunting. When they're inactive, you got to mess around with finesse techniques and jigs and bait and so on. But when they're active, they'll just nail a crankbait like that. Okay, one more look. We're going to get it back in the water. That's a beautiful trophy fish.
Oh, beautiful.
Yeah, well done, Aaron. Get him in the water real quick. He barely fits in that net. I like that.
Yeah.
I'm going to hold him by the tail just so he revives, because we have to handle him a little bit to do that careful removal of the hook. Big fish like this are very valuable. We want other people to catch them.
And in one future second, of the resource
ready
right
to
there.
Go. And there he goes.
Beautiful.
Well done, Aaron. High five.
Nice.
Good one. Aaron, we got us a northern.
I could have grabbed it right here. It came right up.
I don't, you know what? There's no way you're getting that hand around its back.
No, that's a big
look
fish.
Look it. I don't
Very
think.
Nice.
Gorgeous northern. You know what? He's not ready.
No, I can tell.
I don't want him to throw the husky jerk.
Oh!
Can you tell he's not ready? That's the way of a pike's communicating with you.
Yeah.
We've got overcast skies, so we are fishing pretty shallow. You can see the shoreline's right there. And literally, that's where our shore lunch spot was. So we came out here and just started casting. Aaron's got that swim bait on. I put a husky jerk, and it's a smelt color.
I don't even see the husky jerk.
No, I think he grabbed it. He wanted it.
Oh, nice.
Wait, it's not a musky. Pike do that? Head shake and try to jump? Now, I don't know, Aaron, I kind of feel for you. How are you going to do this?
It's thick.
I know it's thick.
Look at that.
Have you got it?
That's a beautiful fish.
You hold death grip, okay? Really, really tight, Aaron. You got it. Good job.
Look at that fish.
You know what? That's a nice northern.
Beautiful. Look how thick it is.
Okay, let me see if I can just... The pliers almost went overboard.
That's why I always carry two of the jaw spreaders with me on a pike trip, because they thrash their head and those things come out and they land in the drink more often than not.
I think we need a little bit longer pliers. Okay,
those
got that one out.
There
you know
go.
What? Did that as well as I could. Okay, he's a gorgeous
That's a
fish.
Pattern too.
Let's get him over the side and hold him so he revives, if
Very
he can.
Nice.
Boy, he gave up a good fight. He nailed that thing too.
Oh, well, let's let her go.
Okay.
Beautiful.
Way to go.
Nice. Good fish.
Hey, no, when I said, All yeah, right. well done, Aaron. Thank you for reviving them. When I said earlier that we're using a new color in the husky jerk, this is called a smelt color. And you can see here, it actually looks just like a smelt.
So
the
head,
it's got a little bit of light color, almost like it's bumped itself on the bottom. But it's a very natural color, just that kind of a greenish back and kind of blue sides. And the white isn't really bright white. And in clear water, I think that definition is really important. So I don't know that there's smelts here in God's Lake, but there's probably bait fish that are very similar to that, maybe not that long. But that pike didn't hesitate. Fishing one of the back channels that averaged about 20, 30 feet and then dropped to about 50 feet. I put a spoon on, a big wake from Blue Fox. Aaron's got a tail dancer, number 13. So we haven't seen this fish. I mean, we've only been trolling about 15, 20 minutes. So we're using trolling rods with counter reels for trolling and the Suffolk A32 line.
I had out exactly 125 feet.
Okay, I got to, you
so,
know what?
It's good to have the line counter to replicate that too.
Yeah, I think the tail dancer was probably down about 30 feet. Because at 150 feet of line, you're down there at a moderate speed. We are using barbless hooks because that's the regulation in the province of Manitoba. But as long as you keep pressure on the fish, usually you do okay. And lake trout are notorious for that head shaking.
Oh yeah.
See, it didn't fight
Strong.
That hard.
No.
It didn't fight that hard when you had it,
no, it
back
came up
from
pretty...
the boat. And that's classic, because the water's still pretty cold once you get below the surface.
Okay, beautiful.
See if I can gently get it in the boat. And I can hear it, it's releasing
nice.
Some air. Look, isn't that a nice lake trout?
Beautiful.
Right here from Elk Island Lodge. You can get these, you know, from in the open water season all year long. In the summertime, you gotta go deeper for them, but right now you can just flatline for them.
And
what
they get
a gorgeous
big.
Fish.
They get over 40 inches here.
Oh yeah.
Over 30 pounds.
It's the mount at the lodge, gorgeous. That big fish, you know.
Massive.
Okay, Aaron,
Beautiful.
We'll get the hook out. And
yep.
I'm gonna just hold it. So it's got lots of energy. Careful, we don't want to break those hooks. Nope. They're already barbless. You know what? He wasn't going to get off. You hooked it really well.
Very
the tail dancers have very good hooks. So that's one nice thing about it. They're designed for big fish. Okay, I'm going to get him in the water and make sure he's got his energy back before we release it. He's probably got tons of energy because that water's still pretty cold.
Beautiful looking
fish. Can I switch hands here? Oh, guess what? No way. Yeah, I thought I was going to switch hands and that fish just exploded.
Beautiful.
Now, this is the tail dancer that caught it. You know, I have so many memories of getting large walleye in the Bay of Quinte, casting these things and trolling. Yep. Here we are in northern Manitoba. We're about an hour and a half plane ride from Winnipeg, fishing God's Lake. And I'm telling you, this place is amazing. You can see the islands behind us. There's so much structure and a mixture of shallow and deep water. And we're staying at Elk Island Lodge. But this is the lure that produced that nice lake trout. It's the tail dancer number 11. It goes down to 30 feet. It's got that big lip bill that goes right down. It just has an amazing action. And that color is perfect. It's like a trout color. I think that is rainbow trout.
Closed captioning of this program is brought to you by MD Marine Insurance. Boat insurance made easy.
We just stepped out of the boat here and we decided to come over and fish some of these rapids by some behind some boulders and around the rapids. I just hooked up with this beautiful, beautiful trout. Incredible. Got it on the metric spinner and that is absolutely stunning. Look at the colors on that fish. I could catch these all day, every day of my life. Beautiful. Has to be my favorite trout by far. And there's no scales on a brook trout either. Unlike a lot of the other types of trout, the brook trout don't have any scales at all. Just beautiful coloration on them. All right, let's let this one go. Hey, I'm just gonna get the hook out down here while he's breathing in the water. Wow, that's a single hook on the metric spinner. I really like the single hooks as opposed to the treble hooks. You really seem to get a good hook set. Had them right in the good part of the mouth. Even barbless, they're still tough to get out sometimes with the big singles. Beautiful. Absolutely gorgeous. Look at that thing swim away. That is a pretty sight. Just sulking down there right now, catching some energy.
You know, I love to fish, and I especially love wilderness fishing adventures, like the one that we're on. In just a few minutes, we're going to have a great shore lunch with fresh fish. But one of the things that really put a damper on a lot of outings is bugs. One of the things that I like to use is called the insect defend patch, and I'm holding these packs in my hand. What the insect defend patch is, it's a B1 vitamin. It's actually called thiamine, and each patch has 75 milligrams of it. And inside this package, there's a little alcohol swab. And the way you use this patch is, you pick a spot, maybe on your shoulder or on your arm, and you take the alcohol swab and just wipe the area just to get our own body oils off it. And then you take the patch and you just place it on you. It takes about 6 or 8 hours to work, but it'll last for up to 24 hours.
Beautiful. Looks like you have a nice fish on.
This is amazing. You know what? I think he's almost done fighting.
Yep.
I've got him out of that current. If you want to slowly slide that net underneath.
Got him.
Beautiful.
Beautiful.
Okay. I'm gonna put the glove on so I can hold them properly.
Yep, I'll just leave them in the water.
Yep. You know, this is amazing that you have the option when you're staying at Elk Island Lodge to fish for Trovy Northerns, walleye, trophy lake trout, even get the odd whitefish and then fly here to get these beautiful brook trout.
It's a short little flight here.
Yeah, we're gonna be releasing this guy. So I'm just wetting my glove. If you wanna bring the net in, Aaron, I don't know how deep it's hooked. Beautiful. Looks like a female. So I'm gonna hold it up. You can see that spinner. Aaron was casting the spoon, which is probably the number one lure when it comes to casting for brook trout, especially big ones. I've got that Vibrex spinner, and that one's called a bullet. It's got a pink bell and a longer blade, more of a willow leaf blade. And it seems to have worked.
Very well.
He's got two of the, one is up in the maxillary. No, well, he hit a little bit down current. So I think that actually helped because when he went to hit, the hook set itself really well. Isn't that beautiful? Right
gorgeous,
here from the God's River,
fish.
Elk Island Lodge. I'm just gonna suspend it in the water because we're releasing all these fish, trying to handle them as little as possible. Such beautiful.
It's a trophy fishery because they release them all the time.
Beautiful trout. Love the vermiculations.
Beautiful, nice.
There he goes.
Good release.
Now you know what? There's a big difference in spinners. I know you probably have a favorite spinner that you like to use. If you don't mind holding this one up, that's the one
this
that I caught it on. Okay, so these are all really good trout spinners, but I'll tell you the main difference. So the Vibrex, which is a real classic lure, this is the classic Vibrex, even though it's got the bright blade.
It's the bell right there.
Yeah, you can see the bell, but look at the blade difference. Let's give them a close-up of the blade. The one that's in Aaron's hand is much slimmer.
And it's actually on the shaft,
it's
as
not
opposed
on
to this is on a clevis.
Yeah, that's right. So using the right spinner and also the way you fish it can make a really big difference. A lot of times if you cast it upstream or three-quarter and retrieve it with the current, the spinner will be able to swim down and work deeper. If you cast obviously three-quarter downstream and the current catches it, the spinner's gonna stay more on top in the upper water column. But sometimes they hit one or the other. So you gotta really experiment to see where the fish are gonna hit.
Canadian Sport Fishing is brought to you by Suffolk. Always use the best line. Yamaha. Conquer outdoors. Defend products. Eco-friendly protection from biting insects. Dickies. Quality workwear since 1922.
Hi, I'm Greg Dick, and this is my wife, Lindsay, and I'm the owner of Elk Island Lodge, and Lindsay and I have been in the industry for over 20 years, and we're on God's Lake. It's Elk Island Lodge in northern Manitoba, where we fish for pike, walleye, lake trout, and brook trout on the legendary God's River. We offer full service, 4 and 8 day trips, guides every day, all your meals prepared by our Red Seal chef. We have wonderful accommodations. We can accommodate up to 50 guests. We traditionally fish for a lot of trophy fish at God's Lake because God's Lake is one of the best lakes in Manitoba for all 4 trophy species.